Dyslexia is a poorly understood disorder, but one Dutch designer may have just cracked the code. Hey guys, Tara here for DNews, and something we haven't really discussed on this show before is dyslexia, despite the fact that it affects such a large portion of the population. It is by far the most common learning disability, but it can be difficult to understand for people who don't actually suffer from it. A common misconception is that people who have dyslexia are stupid or below average intelligence, which is not the case. In fact, in order to qualify as dyslexic, a person must be of average or above average intelligence. It's simply a neurological disorder that prevents someone from reading and occasionally speaking properly. The biggest misconception is that people who are dyslexic can only read or write words backwards, which can sometimes happen, but only in a small percentage of dyslexics. Most people who suffer from it have more trouble with identifying words and grasping the phonetics and pronunciations of them. They might have trouble spelling or reading aloud or comprehending what they're reading, and all of these symptoms can vary depending on age. By adulthood, most people with dyslexia learn to comprehend words pretty well, but they might still have trouble spelling or reading as quickly as other people their own age. In some cases, brain trauma or serious ear infections can lead to dyslexia, but for the most part, it is a genetic disorder, thought to be caused by a phonological processing impairment. Phonological processing is what allows us to bridge the gap between reading and writing. We learn what letters make up certain words, how those letters are pronounced in combination with each other, and then we piece those sounds or phonemes together to make words. Once we learn them, that's it. We pretty much know them forever. But people with dyslexia face a lifelong battle that's helped only through very targeted training. Fortunately, a new approach invented by Dutch designer Christian Boer aims to alleviate some of the pain associated with reading and recognizing typeface. Boer, who is dyslexic himself, says that people like him will often unconsciously switch, rotate, or mirror letters in their minds. And traditional typeface, which has very consistent strokes, can make it hard to distinguish one letter from the next. A B, for example, is really just a backwards D, and an N, likewise, is just an upside down U. So for his thesis project back in 2008, he sought to create a typeface where each letter appears unique. By making all of the letters heavier on the bottom, it prevents the reader from turning them upside down in their head. Letters that look highly similar, like lowercase p, b, and d, have been subtly italicized to make them more distinct. And by lengthening the ascenders and descenders, which is the part of the letter that stretches beyond the normal length, like the bottom part of a p, it makes them easier to tell apart. He also added more space in between letters and words, as well as bolded punctuation marks in capital letters, so people can clearly tell when a sentence is supposed to end. Obviously, these changes won't be a cure-all for absolutely everyone, since dyslexia can come in many different forms. But it does represent a breakthrough in the fight against dyslexia, and especially so for the modern age. Plus, it's just kind of awesome. Who would have ever thought, right? What do you guys think? Do any of you out there suffer from dyslexia? And if so, how do you deal with it? Feel free to share your experiences with us in the comments down below. And as always, thank you guys for watching.